Well, right now, we want to continue the conversation on the gender pay gap. For months, we have talked about it on this show from the viewpoint of corporate America. But it's only fitting that we would shine a light on what's happening to the amazing athletes who play professional basketball, specifically the Seattle Storm. And that is the focus of today's Deep Dive, a segment here on the show where we just dive deeper into a topic. Well, first of all, these are professional basketball players who happen to be women. That's the only thing that separates them from the players in the NBA is their gender. Oh, and their salary, that too. This came up yesterday when NBA star Isaiah Thomas from Tacoma wrote an article in part addressing this issue. He said, quote, "We've also got to make more noise about WNBA salaries, way more noise. WNBA players should be paid a lot more than they're getting right now. That's obvious. They are professional athletes and role models and the best in the world at what they do. They should be paid like it. Better salaries are there if we want them to be. Love this. So let's speak up about that," end quote. And that's important to note. WNBA players aren't asking to be paid the same as the NBA. Revenues are different. But there is a huge problem here when you look at the numbers. And frankly, I have to say, when I saw them, I was shocked, and it's pathetic. So let's start with the minimum pay for a male professional basketball player, $500,000 at a minimum. The WNBA, $41,000 for a rookie. The average salary for an NBA player, $6 million. For a WNBA player, $71,000. Well, what about the stars? Surely they are getting rewarded, right? If you're like LeBron James, Steph Curry, you make $30 million-ish. I mean, who's counting at this point? But if you're someone like Sue Bird, $115,500. And here's where things are not equitable. NBA players get 50% of NBA revenues. And in the WNBA, there's no requirement. And so right now, they're getting just 20% of the WNBA revenue. So it turns out, if you look at what the referees are making in the NBA, they make more than our Storm players. And according to the WNBA Players Association, 70% of them have second jobs playing overseas to supplement their income. Oh, it's sad, but we do have some game changers who are trying to make a difference in many other areas where people are impacted by this. We are joined by Amy Nelson. She's CEO of The Riveter, a game changer for us.
Right.
And Jonathan Bisotto, GeekWire.
Chairman of GeekWire. And you've pledged to only invest and sponsor, if I could use that word, female-founded companies?
That's correct, yeah.
Because of this, one of these reasons that we just addressed?
Exactly, that's right. In fact, this is an issue I'm so passionate about. I mean, my own background, I saw how I was born to a single mother in a bad part of Brooklyn in the late 60s, where I saw how hard she struggled to make ends meet, earning 67 cents to every man's dollar.
Wow.
Sadly, in the year 2018, as we've seen, that economic disparity between the genders still exists. And it's just a little bit better if you're actually a woman of color. It's still about 65, 67 cents for every man's dollar for the same job, same education. So I've put my weight, as it were, and my own resources in terms of supporting women, supporting a lot of female-owned businesses, and really talking about how we can do much better these days.
Yeah, so Amy, tell us about what The Riveter is doing to address this issue.
Yeah, absolutely. So Jonathan is one of our investors, which we're so proud to have him on our team. The Riveter is building female-forward work and community spaces. So we work with entrepreneurs, we work with small businesses, and everyone in between. And we aren't just women only. So we welcome all genders, including men. And that was really important for us because, and Jonathan and I have talked about this a lot, but men still meter the oxygen in so many ways in America.
Yeah.
That's why it was so important in your last segment why Isaiah Thomas spoke out about women's salaries in the WNBA. We need men to speak up about the pay disparity and the pay gap and to help work so we have a future where more women are in leadership.
Is this just because of historically we've, you know, built this country, so to speak, men are getting the jobs, women, oh, they're staying at home with the kids, so if they want to work, you can work, but you're getting paid a little less, and we're still doing that today? Do you think that's a problem
yes,
that we have?
Yeah, absolutely. I think there's a lot of institutionalized sexism. There's a lot of kind of historical framework that I think needs to be dismantled.
Right.
And it can't happen overnight. We can't be super angry about it or rage against the machine. We have to actually work together, work better together, as it were, to dismantle what's bad. had, and there are a lot of really great things that we can do. This is why I actually so admire Amy for having it built the Riveter, to not be exclusive, women only, because
right.
I think men, it's important for men to be allies and to be part of the conversation, and for men and women to work together on these issues.
So if you're not a CEO, what can men do, Spike, right now, like in their sphere of influence?
I'll give you three things. I talk about, you know, a lot of things in my book, Better Together, but the first three things that I'll talk about are one, the concept of listening louder, which is don't mistake women's language. Oftentimes there are bids for inclusion in the language. Don't mistake those bids for inclusion in meetings, in pitches, as weakness. Understand it, really listen and understand the contents of what someone is saying instead of judging them by,
right.
you know,
That's
how kind of
powerful.
Assertive or not they are. Another thing that I would give is don't co-opt a woman's ideas and call it out when it happens. I've had countless female colleagues tell me that they'll have a great idea in a meeting, and it kind of gets glossed over. 5 minutes later, a guy says the same thing,
oh,
and everybody's
no.
like, yeah, awesome, you know. So call that out when it happens. Yeah, you have something
and
to
And I would say, when you're call it out when it happens. Oftentimes, when I was in corporate America, it would happen in a meeting, and a guy would come up to me in the hallway afterward, alone, and say, hey, I know someone, you know, kind of repeated your idea and took it as their own, or someone was talking over you.
Ooh.
And I would say, why don't you note that in the meeting around the table
right.
so you can all hear it.
Speak up.
Yes.
Yeah, one
right.
quick third one. I know we have to talk about the event, too.
Yes, so the quick third one is be really, really aggressive about your hiring goals. When more women are present, whether it's at senior management or CEO or on your board, great things, better things happen. You're more profitable as a company, you get a higher return on investment. So do what some of my friends do, which is double or even triple your employee referral bonuses to bring in more women and underrepresented minorities. That stuff works. And then it's gonna hit the bottom line.
Wow, that's so cool.
Yeah.
So is this the reason you're bringing Jane Fonda in? Tell us about the event at the Riveter.
Yes, we're so excited. So Jane Fonda is coming to the Riveter Capitol Hill. And she is talking with us about one fair wage. Restaurant workers are an enormous population in America. Almost half of women in America work in a restaurant at some point in their lives. And women in restaurants aren't paid a fair wage. It leads to more cases of sexual harassment and discrimination. And so we're working to support these organizations that are working to help women. So Jane will be here with us on September 11th at the Riveter on Capitol Hill, and we're thrilled.
And as you know, she's phenomenal. So we should all come.
I think
everyone.
And we're giving, I know we're
giving away
so
a couple
over,
tickets.
Yes, we're over time, but
we're
I feel like we have to get this in there.
We will. I think we're going to be talking to folks about how we're going to do that at the end of the show.
Okay, we have to save it till then.
I believe so. Oh, no, we're telling now. Okay.
Yeah. So we're giving away tickets to this event. So two tickets, and two people chosen, and you'll get two tickets for each of you.
Right.
Text us why you would like to go to an event like this. What would it mean to you? Text us that to 206-448-4545.
Pick them at random?
We'll pick them. Well, that's a good question for the producer. I think we're going to, I'm not sure. I'm sure Megan... I have voices in my head.
Hey guys, so if everyone text in what this event would mean to you, and I will, we will go ahead and we'll pick two people to win two tickets, and we'll announce that tomorrow.
Perfect.
Okay.
Thank you for clarifying.
We love our producer. Thank you guys so much for joining us.
Such
a rich conversation.
Yes.
I'm so glad you're trying to do something about this issue.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yay.
All right.
Talk to you
Coming
soon.
Up next, we've got information on disaster preparedness. Next segment.
Yeah.
So it's important.
Yep. Stay with us.
Stay with us.